same in other countries. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Yvonne, and thank you for your attention. I will first give a little wrap about what we do in Nigeria, this kind of proposal. But before I do that, I would like to mention that the idea is not only restricted to these two countries. There are some other countries where citizens are proposing that the new oil should be left in the ground where it belongs. I know citizens of the Lofoten area of Norway are campaigning that oil should not be drilled because they caught spawning ground and it will affect the fisheries in that area. It's all part of defending the ecosystem. Of course, we also base our argument on the fact that if you don't bring out the carbon at all from the ground, then you are reducing carbon emissions at source. This doesn't require technology for carbon capture and storage. It's natural, it will not fail. You don't have to invest money on it. Just leave the oil where it belongs, right in the ground. Nigeria has been a very difficult case for us to make this kind of proposal because over 85% of our foreign earning comes from crude oil. And the government is looking for ways to expand this and earn more money. But there's a big disconnect between government revenue and people's well-being. And we believe that this gap should be bridged. And one of the ways that this gap can be closed up is by making removing policymakers' eyes from crude oil money and actually reinvesting in other areas of the economy, for example, agriculture. Because on the African continent, most of the food is produced by small-scale farmers and they require support, which was once available, but was destroyed by the SAPs, the structural adjustment programs of the IMF and World Bank in the 80s especially. So Nigeria produces about 2.2 million barrels of crude oil a day when the oil fields are quiet. But true, for most of early part of this year and late last year, there was a lot of violence. So sometimes crude oil production reduced to 1 million barrels, sometimes less than that. But right now there's peace, so oil production is going up again to about 2.2, 2.3, according to the quota allowed by the Organization for Petroleum Exporting Country. But now this production, since 1958, when oil became a commercial income earner for Nigeria, that's 51 years ago, oil has actually destroyed the economy, destroyed infrastructure, affected the politics, affected everything negatively. One would think that oil would bring about a positive transformation, but it's been very negative influence on Nigeria. And we fear that it hasn't the same effect on many other countries besides just Nigeria. Now, production of oil has meant, in practical terms, dumping of over 600,000 barrels of toxic produced water into the Niger Delta environment every day. It has meant 300 oil spills by official record every year. But unofficially, you can understand that it's about one oil spill a day. And these oil spills are never adequately cleaned up. So the people living in this area have water bodies, farmlands that are completely polluted. And oil would not last forever. In fact, a former oil minister of Saudi Arabia said that the stone age did not end for lack of stone. So the crude oil age would not actually end for lack of crude oil. So we believe that this is the time to begin to think away from crude oil and invest in clean, the word clean is becoming almost dirty. We talk about clean coal, there's nothing like clean coal. Move to renewable energy and forget about crude oil. Because, I just mentioned part of the pollution, deforestation, the cutting of seismic land, from the exploration stage to the production and utilization, everything is negative. Deforestation, to survey for where there's oil, the oil spills during drilling, the toxic waste being released to the environment, oil spills when the oil is being pumped to the export terminals, and also gas flares. I hope you're okay. Okay, gas being burnt 24 hours every day from the gas that comes out as crude oil being extracted. This is about 24 billion cubic meter worth of gas burnt every year, estimated conservatively at $2.5 billion a year. Now, this is a whole lot of waste, but that the economic waste is not really the problem. The problem is that it's causing a lot of health impacts, asthma, bronchitis, cancers, and all kinds of diseases. Now, we have proposed to the government, on the 26th of November, my organization handed over a proposal to the government formally. We started campaigning late last year, but formally last month we handed the proposal on leaving new oil in the soil. We're asking for there should be no exploration for new oil at all. And because the government is very sensitive about the economy, how much money they earn, we've also made a proposal to show how they will not lose any money. It's an interesting thing about the proposal we're making. And I'll just let you into it. Number one, the situation is that there's a lot of oil theft going on in Nigeria. And recently, top government officials, in fact, the Speaker of the House of Representatives in Nigeria, disclosed to the media that about an equal quantity that is being exported officially is also being stolen. Which means if Nigeria produces 2 million barrels to sell into the international market, an additional 2 million barrels is being sold unofficially. And